Eta Carinae. Of the estimated 300 billion stars in our galaxy, Eta Carinae may well be the biggest and brightest of them all. Weighing in at 150 times the mass of our Sun, it is 5 million times as luminous. Huge stars like Eta Carinae have very short, turbulent lives. In the 1840s, Eta Carinae became unstable and blew off as much gas as 10 suns. At the same time, it released as much visible light as a supernova, which usually destroys a star. Eta Carinae survived the explosion, but the outburst produced two expanding lobes of hot gas that continues to expand outwards at over 2 million kilometers per hour. Figure 10, Eta Carinae, visible image. This image, by the Hubble Space Telescope, shows two huge billowing lobes of gas and dust expanding in opposite directions at 2 and 8 o'clock. Between them is the very active central star, which is hidden deep within a dusty shroud. The lobes are surrounded by a less dense cloud of dust and gas. Each lobe is bigger than the entire solar system. Figure 11, Eta Carinae, an infrared image. The infrared emission of Eta Carinae originates from the dust ejected by the star during several huge outbursts within the past several hundred years. The dust produced by the stars can be silicate, like sand, or carbon, like soot. The highest intensity infrared emission comes from the central region around the equator of the central star, where the dust is thickest and is represented by a speckled texture. The diagonal lines within the outermost boundary line denote the coolest layer of infrared emission. Figure 12, Eta Carinae, a radio image. This image is the same scale as the optical in infrared. The highest intensity comes from the region closest to the central star. The radio emission is generated as the intense winds of hot gas leaving the star smash into the surrounding dusty gas. Figure 13, Eta Carinae, an X-ray image. This image, taken by the Chandra Observatory, is zoomed out from the previous three images, all of which fit into the central spot, or nebula, a cloud of gas that surrounds the central star. As you touch the image, you can identify a horseshoe-shaped region of ultra-hot gas surrounding the nebula way beyond the dusty lobes imaged by Hubble. This gas, at a temperature of 3 million degrees Celsius, that's 5 million degrees Fahrenheit, and spanning 2 light-years, was ejected by Eta Carinae in a previous explosive outburst. Eta Carinae will end its life with an immense supernova explosion. It could happen any day. Let's now take a look at two former superstars that have already suffered that fate.